Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sudarshan and welcome to the session today. Our target and topic for today is yoga. We are going to talk about yoga today, and I want a lot of members who should come across and actually, I'm going to put up a lot of practical, exercise and formats which you can use in your regular fitness also. Explain you basically the importance of why yoga in our daily regime. At the same time, we will do some asanas as well as relaxation techniques which actually can help us to attain benefits from this gift that the Indian civilization has given us, which is yoga. Okay, so to start with, basically, what does yoga means? Yoga has over 20 meanings, but then, just to tell you, one of the meaning is union. It is the union of mind, body and soul. And the best part about this particular format that has come to us through Indian origin, the whole Eastern, it has come to us through the Eastern civilization. The best part about this is that the breathing pattern which it involves, okay. None of the workouts actually tend to give you a clear idea about the breathing patterns, but this is what happens in yoga. It's in fact, breathing is one of the things which you are supposed to attain with the asanas, and the moment you start doing that, you actually start collecting that energy and you actually start feeling that synchronization that comes from mind, body and the overall soul. So that's the difference, and that is where it's very important that yoga should be a part of your regular regime. I'm going to give you a few, I'm also going to talk to you about a few asanas when we discuss in detail about the whole yoga aspect. But just to tell you that a lot of people have this feeling that yoga is about some exercises, it's just about some asanas. It's actually one or two of the steps that we take towards nirvana or towards moksha. In what is basically moksha, or rather if you talk about nirvana, it's basically about getting into that level of awareness and the level of meditation where you are synchronized with nature, okay, with the moment of time. So that's the best part about yoga, and there are 8 steps to come to this particular state, attain the state of nirvana. And asanas happen to be only one of the stages where we feel that asanas is all about this, yoga is all about these asanas, this is what we tend to feel up, but that's not the case. And most of the modifications that are done by Western culture, where they have come up with power yoga, they have come up with heat yoga, they have come up with even beer yoga these days. So these are all basically some of the other modifications that are happening, but it is nothing but trying to mold and change your poses into something different and then show up that, like, right, okay, this is something what we are presenting as yoga. Basically the overall structure of the yoga remains the same. All what changes a little bit is the pattern, or you bring about some modifications in that. So thanks to the Western culture, because of which it has become so popular, and of course, but the roots have always originated here from India. So I'm gonna take about 5 asanas now, and if you guys can do with me, that would be something great. And we will also end this session with a relaxation technique, okay. And I will strongly suggest you guys to go through these relaxation techniques, because this can be applicable in any of the workouts that we do. It can be applicable in any kind of session that we are doing, because end of the day, relaxation is something which will help you to rework your energies, help you to recover from all that you have done in your workouts, and get you to the best of your performance on the for the next day. So I think relaxation is something which we always tend to forget, Okay, and relaxation essentially doesn't involve stretching. It's not just about stretching, but it is also about how you tend to, relax yourself in terms of breathing, in controlling your breathing, controlling your overall physiology is what matters to a great extent. So guys, let's start with something, let's start with few poses now. I think what I'm going to do is I will talk to you about few poses which can actually be done. They're general poses, but they're very, very effective. And if you start doing them in your regular regime also, it's going to benefit you a lot. So you all guys can hear me, and how many of you are doing with me? Can I have some response here? How many of you are doing with me? Can you give me a wave there? All those who are planning to do this with me. Let me see. Okay, how many people do I have here? I have Anupriya, I have Manish, I have Mr. Gowda, I have Vaibhav, I have Sumit, I have Shailendra, I have Rajiv. Okay, so we have quite a bit of people here. Okay, great. Thank you so much guys for being there. Thank you for watching this. And just to tell you, this is our third live session. Before this, what we did was a session on exercise versus activity, as well as we had a session about introduction of exercises. So these were the last two sessions that we had done. Okay, so let me now just start a bit of actual practical sessions with you. So we will not really have a very, very clear. Am I audible? Can you all respond? Am I audible to you all? So we'll not have a very, very, I think, not exactly a very clear kind of picture, but I will still try to give you something really good. Okay. All right. So if you guys can see me now, I'm adjusting the camera. Okay. So this particular position itself is actually a yogasana. Okay. Where, you are trying to sit on your knees. If you see, I'm actually sitting on my knees. Okay, so now you can keep putting up your questions, and once I'm done with these practical poses, then I will come up to the questions and I'll be happy to answer all your questions. Now this position is where you sit in, this is called Vajrasana, where you're sitting on your knees. Okay, and what you can do is that if you can put up your hands over the tummy area on both sides, okay, and then take a deep breath. As you breathe out, you just bend forward. You just keep bending forward. And hold that position. Now, a lot of times people feel that going down, you're supposed to just, hold position, stop breathing. No, you don't have to do that. All you have to do is that as you keep going down, you continue your breathing. Okay, just try to maintain that position a little better. Now this particular pose is very good for digestion. It's advisable, if you have this, if you try to do this particular pose after having your meals, that could be after lunch or after dinner. So even doing it like 2 to 3 times in a day, it's very effective, and it should certainly do a lot of benefit. So I'll suggest all of you to kind of do this, holding your hands here, and breathing pattern is very important. Whenever you try to go down, try to breathe out, because as you're going down, you cannot just hold on to your air inside your chest and then try to bend forward. So all you have to do is breathe in and breathe out as you go down. This way. Okay, another modification in this pose, which is very, very beneficial, is you again get into Vajrasana, get your hands up, breathe in, and then as you breathe out, keep your spine straight, keep your hands straight, go down, your buttock should be touching down to your heels, okay, and as you breathe out this way, keep stretching your spine as much as possible. This is an excellent stretch for your spine. It is advisable for upper spine stretch, even the low back stretch. If you can hold on to your tummy, if you can hold on to your good contraction for your abs, you can actually stretch your spine in a very good manner. keep reaching out with your upper limbs, and stretch your upper back as well as the lower back. Breathe in once again. Breathe out. Relax. This is a very effective pose when it comes to stretching your back. Okay, so I think this is again is for people who end up having a upper back pain or even the pain around the the scapular area. So this happens to be a very good stretch for that. Okay, the next one is I'll show you a nice spine stretch. Okay, so the position for this particular exercise is this way, cross leg. It's cross leg in this manner, as you can see. And because you tend to hold your pelvis in this manner, let me just come a little forward. Because you tend to hold your pelvis in this manner, okay, your spine gets straightened up on its own. Okay, there is no option for the back but to get straight. So this actually holds up your spine in a very good manner. Okay, now from here on, the leg which is above, just take the hand on this, and the other hand should be going from the back side. Okay, as it goes backwards like this, breathe in. As you breathe out, go down. This is an excellent stretch for your hip as well as for your low back. This is an excellent stretch for runners. It is also a very good stretch for the cyclist. For a lot of people who get into cycling, it basically helps to stretch up the hip flexors and extensors. So I think it's a very good stretch. A simple what you can do is, of course, make sure that you do this for the other side also. Okay, so the right leg is down, the other leg is just above the knee, as you can see. And the leg which is above the knee, right now my left leg is above, so I will take the left hand up and then hold on with the right side. Okay, breathe in. As I breathe out, I come down. Hold this position for about 15 to 20 seconds. Any good stretch needs a little bit of time for the muscle to stretch. You have to stretch the muscle to its complete position from both all the, the origin of the muscle. So give it a little bit of time. Just going down and coming up is not enough. You need to hold it for at least 15 to 20 seconds. If you hold this for about 20 seconds, that is where you really stretch the muscle. Okay, so this was a very good stretch for your spine, as well as a very good exercise. Okay, and one more modification in this, what I can show you is that take up the same position and then simply all you do is lock yourself this way. Now you can see the opposite side. What I'm doing is now I'm taking the opposite side here like this. This is a very good position for twisting. A lot of time when you actually do this position, you can even hear some sounds because your vertebral column tends to rotate in the opposite side and it gives a very good stretch. So normally a lot of these movements are done by chiropractor, but sometimes it can happen naturally also. So this is what you do here, and then try to just look on the other side of the wall completely and stretch as much as possible. Again, as I said, it's very important to hold this stretch for about 15 to 20 seconds. Hold this for about 15 to 20 seconds and then relax. So this is the position where you will feel a very, very good spine stretch. If we change this position here again, this way, and then opposite side, and I go this way. Obviously, you will see that there is not a complete stretch, or maybe both sides are not the same. That's very, very normal. That's absolutely fine. You may see that both sides may not be the same, which is absolutely fine. It's all with practice that you'll be able to do it eventually. Okay, so this was a few stretches that we did in sitting position. Maybe I can show you some exercise in standing positions. But before that, a very good stretch that can actually, which is also called the dog pose. And this particular pose is very, very relevant to stretch
your hamstrings, your calf, as well as your hip area. Okay, and this is a very good pose for in yoga. Okay, so what you do is that, come to this position. Here, this way, okay, put in your hands down and then just take your legs backward, touch the heels completely, okay, your heels should be touching down completely, your hands should be firm on the mat, and as you go back, take the pelvis backwards and do not raise your heel. If you raise your heel, you will not feel the stretch. Let the heel be down, keep it down firmly, and try to push your body from the pelvis. The more you push, a better stretch you will feel. The more you push from the shoulders and your upper body, pushing the pelvis in the backward direction, you will feel a stretch right from the heels to the calf and then eventually the hip area. Okay, so this is excellent, again a very good stretch for your for runners, for cyclists, for people who are regularly into fitness and need to, you know, get into a good stretching regime. This particular stretch should definitely be included in your regular regime. You must do this particular stretch. Okay, then as you know that yoga emphasizes a lot on breathing patterns and yoga emphasizes a lot on the poses. Now this is where it makes a difference, because yoga basically creates a lot of spaces. When we talk about getting into a position, when we talk about putting ourselves into a particular pose, the idea of doing that is it actually improves the flexibility of that area. It actually creates intercellular and intermolecular spaces. Now, when you create this intercellular and intermolecular spaces, this actually helps you to recover. It actually helps you to, you know, the fibers to get re-energized, the fibers to get rejuvenated again, because of which you can feel the recovery. So that's the reason after every exercise, even if it is a 5 to 10 minute stretching, it should always be done. Any stretch that you should do, or for that matter even in these poses, you should be holding that for at least about 20 to 30 seconds. So this should be the idea. Okay, now coming back to the very basic pose of yoga, what we call as Sukhasan. A lot of people, they find it difficult to even, you know, get into this pose. It's not really very difficult. You need a little bit of flexibility. Firstly, what you do is hold on to the first ankle, raise it up, and then cross leg here. And as you do this, the beauty about this pose is that, if I can go a little backward and show you, the beauty about this pose is that as you get into this pose, your spine is straight. Like the other pose that we did, the cow pose, again the spine got straight. Now in this position, all you need to do is focus on the breathing. It's not just, you know, that you just tend to kind of breathe, take short breaths, or don't get into the I'm not saying that you should start with different I'm not getting into the different formats of breathing, which is pranayama and all other of that, because I'm not talking about that right now. I'm talking about very basic breathing. So get into Sukhasan pose, keep your elbows straight, breathe in. As you breathe in, hold that breath in your lungs for a while. Count for 10 and then slowly breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. You know, so this time when we are actually going through this Corona lockdown, there has been a good breathing test which you can do right now. Is if you can breathe in, you know, take a deep breath, take as much air as possible into your lungs and hold that for about 10 seconds. If you can hold up to your breath for about 10 seconds, it only means that your lung sufficiency and your lung capacity is maintained. And if you're not able to do that, it only means that you have already started compromising with your lung capacity and you need a lot of breathing exercises. So this is one tip, or rather a diagnostic kind of test for corona that has been into a lot of literature right now. So guys, this was what we spoke about and discussed about a few poses on yoga. Now I'm looking to see a few questions. Okay, let me check if I have some questions here. So I would like to have some questions now. Okay, you can type in your questions, and or maybe I can just okay. Hi Vaman, hi Chanda, hi Umesh, hi Asavri, hi Gaurav, hi Babu, hi Arun, hi Jayant. So thank you guys, thank you so much for watching this, and I'm sure you can have quite a bit of tips from this particular session that we have done, and you will definitely have a lot of value for this whole information. You want me to show Shukhasan once more? Okay, I'll do that. There's a lot of movement, you know, because okay, anyways, so yeah, so Sukhasana is not a very difficult pose, yes, but if you talk about the flexibility that needs to be maintained, or rather the kind of flexibility we have at this level, it is a little difficult, but still not if you are regular with workouts, shouldn't really be a problem. Okay, so one leg is straight up, and then take the other leg up like this, so that both the heels, or rather the flat portion of your feet, should be facing. You can see them, both of them. It's not like a cross leg position in which you sit. Okay, so it's not a cross leg position. It's where you are crossing them, as well as it's on each other. And this, at the same time, once you do this, your pelvis gets locked. Now, because the pelvis gets locked, the spine comes into a straight position. It's a very good stretch for your ankles also, but not really suggested for people who have ankle problem or have had ankle injuries in the past, maybe 6 months, if fresh like 6 months. Okay, and all you do is keep your back straight and follow a breathing pattern. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. All you can do is also hold on to your breath. As you breathe in, hold on for about 10 seconds and then breathe it out. Let's do that once again. Breathe in. And breathe out. So guys, now I'm going to take you into a relaxation technique of yoga. And this is also in a way, followed by Shavasana. This is also called Shavasana, which is something what we do once we are done with all the asanas for yoga. But a lot of people tend to, take Shavasana in a wrong way, where they feel that Shavasana is all about lying down, wherein even the lying down position is not correct, and then you end up sleeping. So that should not be the case. So let me just, how many of you are actually doing this with me? Can you wave or can you raise up? How many of you are doing with me? Okay, let me explain to you now how does Shavasana really work. What is the ideal way of doing a Shavasana? So yes, you need to lie down on your mat, okay? Now, as you lie down, it's very important that your head is in a neutral position. It's not shifting left or right, okay? And then your palms are facing upwards. It's facing the roof. Okay, it's facing upwards. Your ankles are rotated a little bit on the outer side. If you see, this is a normal relaxing position which will come to you very often when you are getting to sleep or lie down on your back. Okay, you will always feel to tend to loosen up your ankles and let it go outwards like that. Now that is actually a comfortable and the loose position of your hip joint as well as your ankle joint. If you come to that position, you tend to leave up your joint and they are much relaxed. So starting from the shoulders are facing up, elbows straight up, the hands are facing upwards, okay, starting from the hips. The hip is in a neutral position, buttocks touching onto the ground, relax as much as possible, the back relaxing as much as possible, going down on the knees are a little, I would say, 3 to 5 degrees of bend, because the moment it bends a little bit, it provides further relaxation, and then that further takes your ankle in a rotated position, okay, and the ankle is more on the outer side. So once it is into the rotated position, all you have to do is focus on your breathing. Do not tend to sleep in asana. Do not tend to sleep in shavasana. The moment you start sleeping in shavasana, that is a complete waste of that particular exercise. So you have to, what you have to do is you need to continue with your regular breathing pattern, which is breathing in, breathing out. You have to continuously focus on your breathing pattern. If you are sleeping in that position, it only means that you've had a heavy workout and you needed more rest than the workout actually. So this position is ideal. Even you know, if you tend to just before sleep, if you try to do this particular exercise, you will have a very good sleep. So you should certainly look on to doing something like this. And so how many of you are doing the relaxation technique with me? Should we go ahead with the relaxation technique? Okay, so let me tell you how the relaxation technique works. You have to get into the same position as we told you, the shavasana. You lying down on your back, the shoulders resting, head in a neutral position, elbows and hands are facing upwards. The hip is in a neutral position. Knee is, I wouldn't say really bend, but just rotated a little. That will help it to just bend a little bit. And then the ankles are on the outwards. So this helps you to relax the ankle completely. Now, this is the shavasana position. Now, what you do is that start doing a little bit of contraction of all your muscles. Okay, I'm just changing the position of okay, I'm coming here now, and all you need to do is listen to my commands. If you listen to my commands and see this video again, you will still be able to do the relaxation technique. So what you do is start from your shoulders, and all you have to do is let me just make sure that the sound is very, very clear. So the commands are most important. The moment you listen to the commands properly, you will be able to do it in the right manner. Okay, so once you are in this shavasana position, now there is something called isometric contraction of body. Okay, when I say isometric contraction, when I'm doing this movement, you can see that the fingers are moving. So this is basically a consistent movement where you can even see some movements of the fingers. But if I just hold on to this finger, or rather hold it in this way and do this movement, if you see, there is still contraction. You know, if I'm trying to push my hand both ways, there is still contraction happening. It is not that there is no contraction, but there is no movement happening. So this kind of contraction is basically called isometric contraction. Why am I telling you or explaining you this is because you need to do a lot of isometric contraction when you have to do a proper relaxation technique. Okay, so when I say isometric contraction, it's like contracting from your shoulders. Okay, so when you tend to contract your shoulders, all you have to do is contract your shoulders and relax them. This is the only thing that you have to do. So we will start from the head. Okay, we will start from the top. We will start from the head and the neck area. Once you lie down, the nape of the neck, where you are actually putting up the whole weight, all you need to do is press on to your neck. Press on to your neck as much as possible. Press hard, press on to your neck, and then slowly relax. Now, go down, move on to your shoulders, press on to your shoulders, press, and slowly relax. Now,
you have to move this contraction from your shoulders to your biceps and the triceps area. So when I say you have to contract them, all you have to do is create a contraction of the muscles. There is no movement that is happening. So contract your biceps as well as your triceps. A simple way of doing is that simply putting a little bit of pressure from the back of the shoulders down to the ground or to the mat. So press on to the shoulders and then slowly relax. Now let's go down to the elbow. Press on to the elbows and slowly relax. Your palms are facing upwards. You're not making a fist. You're just putting your palms upwards and facing them upwards. So all you have to do is press that to the ground. Press on to the ground. Press on to the ground. And slowly relax. Now let's start with the lower limb. Let's start from the lower back. Okay, like when you did the shoulders, you already covered the upper back. Now you will do it for the lower back. What you have to do is press on to the lower back. Okay, press it down, press it down, press it down, and slowly relax. Now let's go to the pelvis. You need to contract your pelvis, contract your pelvis, contract, and slowly relax. Now go down to your knees. Tighten up your knees and slowly relax. Now go down to your ankle. Go down to your ankle and slowly relax. So I have my another Zoom meeting now, which is already started for the online training. Yeah, all the guys are ready. Okay, great. Yes. Okay, so that's how you do a complete relaxation technique. You start from your upper body, go down absolutely to your ankles. It won't take more than 5 minutes for you to do this relaxation technique, but it really helps very well to improve your sleep. And doing it just before, just after your workout, or even just before you sleep is an excellent idea. So guys, thank you so much for watching the live session, and I'm looking to see you in the next live session. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. And do put in your questions in the comments below, and I'll be more than happy to answer all your questions. Thank you.